Today, not only are we going to go on an adventure to an ocean monument to battle it and raid it and loot it, but we're also going to turn it into a farm. Hello there, Master Hellish here, and welcome back to my Minecraft Let's Play. We're here in my vanilla survival single-player world, and I don't know why my toolbox is out. Why is my toolbox out? Let's put my toolbox away. You may notice there's a few things going on here, so this is just me testing blocks. I'll have to get rid of that at some point. And this over here is for an upcoming episode. You may be able to tell what it's for by the items inside it. Okay, but I'm not going to tell you what it is. You can have a guess in the comments if you wish. Right, so today we're going to go to an ocean monument, so we're going to need a few different things. I think a bucket with some milk might be a good idea, just in case I want to overcome the mining fatigue at some point. You know what? My bucket's from my toolbox. Let's get a few loads of that. And we've got really good equipment, so that's going to help us. Maybe some potions of strength. I don't think I've ever... Instant health, let's get one of them. I don't think I've ever fought the Elder Guardians with such good equipment on me before. So we've got a few instant health potions, a few apples. We'll just top up on food. We've got plenty of food. There we go. We've got lots of rockets, but again, let's top up on rockets. I'm going to move both of these at some point, so they're going to be more handy. That's just where they ended up. Actually, we ended up with too many rockets. Like, let's go find a cow. And I think we'll use the TNT method to gain entry. Hello, cow. I see chickens. I see pigs. I see horses that look like cows. Or at least have got the mottled complexion of something that may resemble. Let's get higher. Okay, sheep, sheep, sheep. Is this island just completely sheep? Maybe. Okay. Let's head over this way because there was some animals on top of one of these hills. And I think there were some llamas, maybe? Oh, hang on, what we got up here? So this one is chickens, rabbits, and sheep. And this hill, here we go, look. I penned some in when I found that there was two llamas here. So we should be able to bucket ourselves a load of milk. Just in case. Right. That's going to counteract any status effects once we get it. Now I think water breathing shouldn't be too much of a problem because we do have... respiration 3, but we will take some stuff just in case. We'll take some doors. Now we need to take some blocks to build with, and I feel like netherrack is the block of choice here because it's one of the quickest to remove. So we've got some blocks, some doors, milk, some potions, golden apple. I feel like a potion of strength might be a good idea, but invisibility could be good, but no, we won't bother with that. And let's get ourselves a redstone block. And oh, hang on, have we actually even got any TNT? Well, did I use it all up mining in the Nether? Oh no, we have some. Okay, we'll take 5 TNT to help us get quick access. Right then, so I think that's going to be it. We're just going to go over to the monument. I know where it is. We found the monument very early on in this series. It's over there, just past a village on the end of this bit of land. Found it when mapping out the area early on. So I'll fly over there, and we'll go and see what we can do. We'll have a go. I'm not going to cut. I thought I was going to cut, but thinking about it's getting night time. That's better. We've got 10 minutes of daylight now, so at least the sun's rising over there. So from our temporary base, we fly out to the west over these I don't know, I think they're kind of plains. There's the village on the end of the island here. And then we turn a little bit left. And there it is. That's it right here. So we're just going to dive straight in there with some blocks. And we'll go in here and try and just... Oh my goodness. Let's go this side rather than in the middle. Right. Let's try and bust our way in. It'd help if I actually had the correct blocks on my hotbar. So we've got some plate... there. Right. There we go. TNT's in there. We've broken our way in. I'm going to head in now and see if we can deal with what's in here. There it is. I'm going to go straight for it. Right, we've killed it. Now we need to make sure we don't die. So I'm just going to swim in towards the corner. Oh god. Put some blocks down. Great line of sight with these guys. Get the doors out. Stand in the water. There we go. And eat. Ooh, that was a little bit close, I thought. Yeah, okay. So I've done that once. I'm quite happy with that. I think I'll leave the door and the blocks here. And we'll go and do the next one. So let's just rearrange our hotbar. So we've got the blocks. We don't need the prismarine on there. We've got the... Yeah, so we just need the blocks, the door, the TNT. The redstone block got blown up, didn't it? Silly me. I'm going to need a redstone block for each one. Where's our entrance? There we are. Ooh! There's some sponge there, which means this is probably a sponge room somewhere here. That's my first sponge on this server. So what I'll do is I'll go and get some more redstone blocks, and we'll do the other two. Here we go then, we've just flown over the village, it's time for the second run. There's the temple monument thing, it's a monument. We're going to come and we're going to dive down into the water. And we're going to place these blocks as quickly as I can. Because there's quite a few of them around here. Okay, what I might do is let that blow and get out and back again, because that we took quite a bit of damage there, and I don't want to take that much damage. So let's fly in there after our health is restored. There's the hole. Go straight in. Oh, there's the tail of the other guy. Oh god, this is gonna be close. I've got him. Oh, he dropped the sponge. Right, okay. Should be alright if I just hide behind this pillar. Pop our door in. There we go. Our little safe room. Well, there we go. Our health got down to 3 hearts, but we did it. So now it's time for me to go back outside and do the last one. So we should be able to swim outside, okay? Here we go. Just keep swimming. We need to find our exit. There it is. There we go. Right, so we've got our door. We're going to swim round here. Get ready to place some blocks. Where is this guy? He's got to be around here somewhere. Just keep swimming. What about down here? We're well and truly inside now. As long as we keep moving, we're probably going to be okay. Oh my goodness. Right. Safe room. Ah, there we go. We just got the effect. Okay, let's try something different. There's the monument. This is the top room. There he is. I did wonder. There we go. This is going to be easy. There we go. Right, so the Elder Guardian was in this top room, and I have no idea how to get there. So I didn't. When I blasted in, I blasted in just down there. I wasn't high enough. So let's reverse this. So this room here, I needed to go up. But when did I ever enter that room? So that's a dead end. This is a weird sort of lantern room. Oh. So I'd have needed to come up here, round there, and then up again. We need a door. There we go. Let's also eat. There we go. And from here... Oh, right. So I was here a lot. I was going through here, up here, down there. And then I was going, well, what's going on? Why can't I find him? It was usually somewhere... Well, I found him actually around here in the past. It was up there. I didn't notice this opening above me in this room. And if I did notice this opening above me in this room, I might have come down here and gone, oh, look, he's there. Right, okay. Well, we've done that now. Achieve done fantastico. Let's get out of here. Let's actually go out by the hole that I came in. There we go. Right then, so now it's time to turn this into a farm. So what I'll do is I'll just quickly explain that. So I haven't got a particular design that I've got off the internet. I've looked at a few videos, got a few different ideas, and I've decided how I'm going to do it. We're going to just remove the very top little bit of the monument, and then we're going to put in a floor of soul sand. Now, luckily, we have bucket loads of soul sand from our gold trading that we did last episode. I put 3 gold blocks in into the gold trading system, and we got so much resources out of it. It was well over a shulker box of gravel, well over a shulker of soul sand, and there was lots of iron nuggets. We got the charges, we got plenty of the ender pearls as well. So we've got all sorts of materials, but what we're going to do is we are going to strip the top, just the top of this down. We'll make a pad of the soul sand, because that will mean we get bubbles, and when they spawn they'll come up, and at the top we'll have some sort of waterways to collect them into a portal. So let's go get the materials to do that and get building. Ah, take away, take off, take off. Can't take off. There we go. Fine. Right then, folks, as you can see beneath me, they are spawning in the zone and going into the portal as designed. And it's been exactly 21 minutes and 40 seconds. I was going to do this for 20 minutes, but then I pressed the wrong button to record. So let's get out of here. Ugh. And I need to work out which way I need to fly back to the land. So I need to fly that way. Now, unfortunately, there's no easy way to collect the loot. We can't just go down there and get it. We have to get it in the nether. At the moment, if I work out a way to transport that in the nether back up to where I am, that would be rather cool. Maybe at the AFK station, I could have a big storage system and a nether portal where the items get dropped in. But that means I'd have to collect the items in the nether, and then I'd have to transport them upwards in the nether, and transporting up items upwards in the nether is not an easy task because you can't use water streams, but there's probably another way I can do it, and then push it back through a portal. It's not impossible. I would consider that a future possible upgrade. So all we do is nip from here down here, and it's the first stop on our left, and I'm gonna think, oh yeah, look at that. That's from when I was doing the last bit of sorting out. But oh my goodness. So after only 20 minutes, we have a full double chest and nearly a... Well, actually, if you take the hoppers in the back into account, we have 3 chests worth of materials. Which, so if that's 3, that's another 3. So it was 21 minutes divided by 3. Oh, divided by 3 is not great. Well, actually, whilst we're here, let's take some of those materials. Let's take all of the shards and the other bits. There's not many of the crystals, is there? Let's take a few crystals with us. We'll be able to craft them up. And the main reason I want these is to craft is to craft the lantern light thing. Is it lantern? I think it's called the lantern. Let's double check. Sea lantern. There we go. So we can craft a whole load of them and some prismarine bricks. May as well. We can dump them in here. Doesn't quite fit. Let's get rid of that door. And in our light box, we can now stock ourselves up with lots and lots of the sea lanterns, which is absolutely fantastic. So I'll do the maths, and I'll put on the screen how long it will take to fill up that storage. There we go. And I think that is another adventure and another farm all done. Well, that's going to be all for now. Remember, put all your thoughts, ideas, and questions down in the comments section. And if you want to know more about me, my live streams, and my giveaways, go to masterhellish.net. And you can also support the channel there via the Viewer Plus program. I'll see you soon. Take care. Goodbye.